everyone, welcome back to another Counter Side video. So today we're going to be breaking down Serapel and her build. Before that, if you wanted updated Counter Side videos, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so here we are at Serapel. So this girl actually creeps me out with the way she's been designed and she's been chained up and a straight jacket to boot. So again, cool design, a little bit creepy, but we're going straight to the issue at hand. So she is actually a counter Cronenworth puppet troop. So she's a member of that group. So she costs 4 as a defender. She is ground type, but she does all around attack. Okay guys, when we take a look at her stats, so her strengths are her HP and her defense. Both are high stats. HP is at 65,318 and her defense, it is at 1,087. Again, superb stats, but for her weakness is going to be attack. She is only at 2,618. It's actually a low stat for attack. Then you have crit is also at her crit is actually low. Her hit rate is below average and her evasion is actually low. So evasion is actually 0, hit is 923, which can actually be bumped up easily because it's only below average. So it's you can actually raise her hit as you equip her gear. So let's take a look at her skills, guys. So for her skills, so basic attack, it's going to have 2 valid hits, discharges enemy energy, inflicting AoE damage on and around a target. Sorry for that, guys. Levels 2, 3, 4, and 5, total basic attack addition is going to be 20%. Next is going to be her passive skill. So masochistic creator, as I told you guys, she's on the masochistic side. Valid hits is 2. Permanently increases her attack by 1% in response to incoming damage up to 99%. Okay. In Gauntlet, increases incoming damage, decreases all enemies' HP. So she has also a passive that decreases enemy HP by 45% over 3 seconds. This includes ships. Okay. Level 2, 3, 4, it's going to give her a bump on her HP at it's going to be 25%, but at level 5, after every 4th basic attack, she delivers an enhanced AoE attack to the front area. So much powerful attack that can supplement damage for herself. Special skill, hit stun immunity and damage reduction plus 50% for 5 turns as well. Okay, so the passive is actually good. You can actually gear her to enhance her passive. We'll talk about that later. So special skill, it's going to be Painful Monopoly, 24 seconds, valid hits is 2, unleashes her power, inflicting AoE damage on surrounding enemies and forcing them to attack her for 8 seconds. So this is actually very good. This is a taunt for 8 seconds, which is a very long time. Okay guys, so it takes 50% of damage for surrounding and allies and achieves 100% higher defense for 8 seconds as well. So again, this is what makes her very, very good, especially in PvP. The taunt, then the increased defense. Okay, so level 2, 3, and 4 is going to be a cooldown reduction of 4 seconds. So that total lowers her cooldown to 20 seconds, which is pretty much fantastic as well. Level 5 is recovers 30% of max HP after the skill, which again enhances her survivability. So alone, guys, her special skill alone is actually very good in itself. It gives her taunt, it gives her higher defense, and there is HP recovery after you play this special skill. Okay, moving on to her ultimate skill, it's Lacrimosa. It's a 48-second skill. Valid hits is 4, which is nice. Partly reveals her true form, inflicting AoE damage on surrounding enemies. This skill immediately cancels all debuffs cast on her and makes her invisible for the duration. Again, in terms of gearing, you could also let this skill shine. I'll discuss that later as well. So level 2, 3, and 4 damage addition is going to be 25%. And on level 5, stuns all enemies for 2 seconds after the skill hits. Okay, again, overall kit for her is tremendous. At this point, she is going to replace Hilde probably when she gets banned next week. So again, guys, it's now time to build your Serapel by this time. Okay, so here I have with my gear for my Serapel. So at this point, I chose to gear her with all HP. The other choices that you can actually, you know, this is just a choice. The first option would be HP, which I highly recommend. The second would be either they're going to be split. So attack speed so that you can trigger more of her passive skill. And also you can put her on her cooldown because of her two skills as well. So again, it's a choice. So, but I will recommend HP for her because this will improve more on her survivability and as well as her health recovery. Okay, so those are the gear sets. So again, so I have here one, I have a tier 6 already one, but for this one you should change evasion, because again, evasion is not part of what she's built for. So she's a defender, and more or less for her gear stats, I would advise highly cooldown, HP, or hit. So those are the things that you should put here or change: HP, cooldown, and hit. So for me, I still have to change some of these. These I just equipped them because of HP. So this one is okay. This one is okay as well, hit and HP. But these two are, I have to change whether I'm going to go, I think I'm going to go with skill cooldown or skill haste for these two, for the first two, so that I could, you know, have her, you know, skill, special skill, and ultimate skill cycle fast, or kind of improve than it is now. Okay, so in terms of her deployment, so there's a no-brainer in deploying her. She is actually a defender, but usually the most, you know, the value that you get out of her is pairing her with squishy units, because she has taunt. So she what you call this, she redirects all the damage to her. And if you can have small or glass cannon units at her back, that would be the best combo for her. So she can actually tank as long as she's alive. You can actually supplement her with a healer so that she can tank more. And again, a glass cannon or several glass cannons at the back would actually be highly advisable for her. Let's take a look at her special skill at first. So there is her special skill, simple animation. So again, she she does a lot of damage even though she is actually blindfolded and chained and put in a straitjacket. So this is actually amazing. Let's try to use her ultimate skill. So again, she reveals her true form, which is a lot of energy damage and stun as well. So again, let's try to use her ultimate. I like her ultimate because I think this is very key as well in her survivability and also for the survivability of the units at her back. Actually, my final thoughts is up now. If you guys are planning to build her now, because I'm foreseeing Awakened Hilde being banned next week. So going to be a Monday. Try to build her up to 100. That I think would be good. She would be a good pairing with Awakened Yuna at this early stage of their, you know, their release in terms of the game. They would complement each other, I'm sure. She is going to be supreme in both PvP and PvE. Okay, I would rate her a 10 for both. As you can see, if you can remember, PvP load her up with glass cannons for a quick attack. I think she would do good with soldier comps. Fast and squishy soldier comps. She could tank in the front and the rest will have to do the damage to the back. And also, for any content for PvE, she is going to be amazing. If you put her at 110, I'm sure she's going to be a monster. She's actually a monster right now, but she's going to be more of a monster. I'm saying monster in a nice way because she's going to be very tanky for the cost of 4. She will definitely outshine Reginald King. You can only use Reginald King once she's going to be banned. So more or less, she's going to be your top non-awakened SSR defender. So again, guys, she's a must to build for all your content. And try to summon for her if you still haven't. Her banner is still up and you still have time to build her. Okay. Anyway, guys, if you stuck this long in this video, thank you very much. Please do consider subscribing and also click the bell icon and like this video. Guys, take care. Stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.